Mr. Transformers 96 here with another video. We're going to be talking about some newly shown Marvel Legends figures. This time we have the Avengers Infinity War Wave 2. Now we have seen all these figures before, however now we get some better images of them, some new images of them, and some in-package images so you can really see what they come with, how they're packaged, and you know, what Build-A-Figure pieces come with which character. So, so I've done a video talking about it when these were like first shown like officially, so it's now exciting to see the in-package images of them. I am excited for this wave, but I have some mixed feelings about it overall. First of all, the Thor figure, I'm not too excited about, just because we've had several Thors in the past. There is a Thor coming out in a pack with Rocket and Groot, and I really want that Groot, so I plan to get that one anyway. This one isn't super interesting. What I do like about it is his weapon. I think that the axe looks very cool, and I love the fact that it comes with a lightning piece that that kind of wraps around it, so I think that's awesome. His face sculpt isn't great. I definitely don't think that it's very strong. It looks like one of the weaker ones from Chris Hemsworth, which we've seen from Marvel before, from Hasbro, so I am kind of disappointed about it, and it would have been cool if he came with a second head sculpt with the eye patch head. That would be kind of neat. He obviously comes with the arm of Cole Obsidian. Then we have Black Widow. Black Widow is looking kind of interesting. She's one of the ones that I'm more interested in the wave. I think she looks like a solid figure. The head sculpt looks pretty good. I like the fact that she comes with those kind of taser pieces and then the staff that can kind of be combined and formed into like a full electric type of staff. I think that's very cool. She comes with a couple alternative hand sculpts, which is nice. And she overall looks like a solid figure. You know, we've had Black Widows in the past though, so this isn't like super exciting by any means. But I think that she looks pretty solid. And it also looks like the vest piece is a separate piece on her. The piece that she comes with is the torso. It's kind of mangled in there, but it's the full torso for Cole Obsidian, so that's kind of nice. Then we have Ant-Man. This is arguably the one I'm most looking forward to in this wave, because I really like Ant-Man in general. I've always been a big fan of him. I really liked his Civil War look, and this is obviously his Ant-Man and the Wasp costume, which is very similar to the Civil War one. And we never got a Civil War one. We only got one from the original movie, and that one severely lacked when it came to the helmet head. So this one I think looks really nice, because they've nailed the helmet. They have a Paul Rudd head sculpt this time, and he's got like a smirk, which I think is really fun, and I think that the likeness is pretty solid as well. So as a whole, I think that this looks fantastic. I'm really looking forward to this one, and it's one, if not my most anticipated figure of the wave from the regular series. And he comes with the leg for Cole Obsidian. And then one, if not my most anticipated figure of the wave, we have Wasp. Really looking forward to Wasp, obviously being a new character, one that we don't have a Marvel Legends. She's the only MCU figure in the wave that's not the Build-A-Figure that we don't have, or that we haven't had a previous figure of before. So this is definitely nice, and you know, makes the figure kind of fresh. But she looks excellent. I really think she looks spot on. I love her helmets, the wings, the extra Evangeline Lilly, I can't remember how to pronounce her name, but the actress head sculpt, which I think is very nice. She comes with extra hand sculpts. She also comes with an extra backpack piece if you want to display her with the without the wings on, so it's like her wings aren't extended. You can do that as well. And then she comes with the head of Cole Obsidian. And then we have Malekith. Now, I was so happy when they made a Malekith figure, a comic Malekith figure, when it was released in that pack for Comic-Con. I really loved it. I thought it looked great, and therefore I purchased it. You know, I made sure to get that one, even though I didn't buy any of the others from the pack, but that one was a must-have for me. It's a great figure, but I already have that one, and this one is just a repaint, and it's not a good repaint, because I'm not quite sure which version of Malekith they went off of for this one, but it's kind of strange that you got like a dark and light red color scheme going on with blonde hair for him, not like the white, and then just some gold highlights. Like, that's not a Malekith that I really know. The only way I've seen Malekith drawn, like, is with the black and red and the white hair, which is the original one. So I'm just not a fan of this color scheme. And I have one that's far superior. So it's a great figure. I absolutely love the Malekith figure, but the other one's so much better, and I already have it. So this one doesn't excite me whatsoever. If I can just get his Build-A-Figure piece on its own, I definitely will do that. So he comes with the arm of Cole Obsidian. Then we have Black Knight. Black Knight actually looks like a really nice figure. Like, I think that I like the helmet head sculpt a lot, and it looks like he comes with a few different alternative head sculpts, which is cool. He comes with a sword, and he's your standard sculpt of like Zemo and what's that Iron Man villain that came in that Raft Comic-Con pack? I can't remember his name, but him. And those are all ones that I have, so sculpt-wise, there's not much new here other than the cape and the heads. So I do like the heads, don't get me wrong, but I'm just not a big fan of this character. And yeah, it looks like a solid figure, but just for me personally, nothing too special. I wouldn't like be super upset getting this figure, but I certainly would prefer just to skip it and get his Build-A-Figure piece. He comes with the leg of Cole Obsidian. Now, talking about the whole wave as a whole, as well as the Co-op City and Build-A-Figure, you know, in total, this is an okay wave. It has some strong players in it as far as the Ant-Man and Wasp figures. I'm very excited for both their characters and their figures. I'm very excited for them. Black Widow, I'm excited for her figure, not too much her character. And then Thor, Malekith, and the Black Knight. Those are all ones that I'm just not really interested in, to be quite honest. I would definitely, you know, skip probably all three of those and just get their Build-A-Figure pieces if I could. So personally, I'm not super excited for them, which is unfortunate. However, the Build-A-Figure of this wave is what I'm really excited for, which is Cole Obsidian. Now, he looks really cool and really detailed. He just doesn't look accurate to the movie. From what we've seen in all the promotional images and all the figures released by Funko of Cole Obsidian, he doesn't look like that. Like, he has armor on. Like, this is like him without armor, which is odd. So now, There's two reasons for this. One would make it okay, one would be disappointing. The one reason could be that this is based on early concept art of him, and this is obviously not what they went with. So the figure, obviously, when you do merchandising, yeah, excuse me, you have to start about, is I think it's 12 to 18 months before the movie's released that you start with the merchandising. So therefore, a lot of the stuff that comes out is based on old information. And if that's the case, that would be very disappointing because obviously it wouldn't reflect him in the movie. Now, if this is like a portion in the movie that maybe during a battle or something, he gets his armor ripped off or something like that, then this would be really cool and I'd be totally fine with it. But overall, I am disappointed that it's not the armored look, which seems to be a lot more popular, and I just kind of prefer it more. But figure-wise, I think it looks excellent. He looks huge, too, which is accurate to the movie, and he just looks awesome. Now, the only thing that's a little weird here is that, obviously, he's always pictured with his hammer, but when you look at the actual figures in this wave, none of them have his hammer in the box. Just to give you a quick rundown, yeah, his hammer is nowhere to be found, unless it's, like, hidden somewhere, but that's just not going to be the case. So that leads me to think that possibly there's a seventh character in this wave, and that's the one that's going to come with the hammer. Overall, that would be really disappointing, because I don't want to buy seven figures, unless it's a great figure or something, but I'd prefer just to get the six figures, because the wave itself is not too interesting to me. You know, I've got two figures that I want from it, one that I'm okay with, and then three that I don't really care for. So as a whole, I do hope that I can get just most of the Build-A-Figure pieces on you know, cheap on eBay just by themselves, and then of course I'll buy Ant-Man and the Wasp. So we'll see. Hopefully that hammer is released with one of these figures. If it is released with a seventh figure, I hope it's another Black Order figure like Cole Obsidian or Ebony Maw. That would be sweet, but other than that, it would be disappointed if it's not. And also, Cole Obsidian has these two like kind of blasters that he seems to be pictured with more often than the hammer, and it would be really cool if the figure came with that as well. So there you go, that's my thoughts on this second wave from Avengers Infinity War Marvel Legends figures featuring the Cole Obsidian Build-A-Figure. Let me know what you guys think of the figures in package and what they come with, and what you think of the Build-A-Figure as a whole, and thanks so much for watching.